She said, we're not scared. We're not scared of South Carolina. We're not scared of anybody. People should be scared of them. Morrow up ahead after the turnover, had to track it down. Fires a tough angle shot, but that won't drop. They'll get the second effort. Van Litt, the 5'9 grad. Here's Williams, and swishes that in.
Williams missed three games. It was really precautionary. Her foot was a little bit sore, and Kim Mulkey said, knowing postseason was ahead of us, wanted to make sure her starting forward was ready to go.
Way downtown, Johnson will knock that home. Particularly excited. Those two are quite a 1-2 punch. Downstairs, underneath, and finally, Angulofak makes it a basket for Rice in their first points. She had to watch the championship game from the team hotel. She gets a block immediately here, but they're so locked into their team. Reigning national champs on the floor for the first time in this tournament. Gooden gets it outside, and that's a triple by Jackson. Actually, they're going to call it a two.
Absolutely, and we know about the offense, we know about the rebounding, but where I've seen the most improvement since the month of February has been the defensive end.
National championship looking to repeat, looking to become the first back-to-back champ since UConn won three in a row. Van Litt gets a real good look and swishes in a three-pointer.
Out of the timeout, the Owls come out into a 1-3-1, and LSU worked on this a lot yesterday. They were focused on diagonal passing.
And to show other young women, you know, you can be a mom and a great professional as well. And on the scoop, it's Johnson to lay it in.
There are young people out there who have no idea what I just said.
That's right. You know, you're sitting next to somebody who did that an awful lot. The edge of sketch. That's going to be knocked down. Bukanevich with a good shooting.
Well, this is just drive and kick. It starts by Fisher getting downhill. That pulled the defender. They're settling versus working to get high percentage looks.
LSU's three consecutive turnovers. Fisher got it. Nice touch from three to the Fisher triple.
Well, Malia Fisher just screen and pops. And this is what Rice does when they get the ball movement going. And the Owls back to the 1-3-1.
Morrow fighting her way through a double, lays it up and in, so strong. Well, you have two players on your roster who put up those kind of numbers. That'll rattle home Malia Fisher. You're getting a look at why she was her conference tournament MVP.
I talked to another coach in the American, and they just said she is so tough. She's difficult to match up with because it doesn't matter what you do, she's going to find a way.
Speaking of which,
because she can score in so many different ways. Puts it on the floor. This time a little bit of a step back. Blazek's another player for the Owls that needs to get going. She was really big in all four wins in the American tournament for the Owls.
Pull up Pop Williams. Yes, so smooth. The two-pointer. Two-time Louisiana Gatorade Player of the Year who decided to stay home. Down the lane. And Gulifak for two.
The more impressed I was. This young lady is so deceptively quick.
And close off the window for Morrow. Williams on the dribble around the back. And up and in, and a whistle too. Count that.
She's been active. There rips through and goes through the contact for the and one. You are here to win a game.
Team has heard that. Jackson off to Klazak, who lifts a long one and hits it. 24-19 the score.
Again, Rice in the 1-3-1.
Pull up with an answer before anybody else, too.
And that's just great scouting by LSU, but yet another turnover that allows Rice to get out and run.
Son of the pick. Klazak way downtown will sink it. Johnson's pass, thrown away. Klazak again, going one-on-one. Pola with the deflection and knocked it out. Son looking for a guard, finally gets it to Jackson.
Great defense by Pola.
Out of the trap. They got it underneath in any event, and Son will finish that. Jackson on the move.
Great defense by Pola, not letting her use the high on-ball screen.
Klazak can't get off a three, flips it in, just tossed it up there with the shot clock going down and made it. Poe with the heave, had more time to get across midcourt. But how about this score? LSU only by it up there. Well, the shot clock winding down.
The fifth made three is the biggest of the half for Rice.
They were the number 10 seed when they won the American Athletic Conference Championship, and with it, the automatic bid. Underneath, Fisher will lay it in. She sprung free.
Well, this was great set play call from the bench for Rice, and it's just knowing LSU's going to try to deny that high post entry pass.
This just has not been an artistic success. From the corner, long launch there by Klazak, but a second effort will be up and in.
And credit Fisher for staying with that. And that's the pass that LSU needs to make, that diagonal pass. And that's why they can use their height advantage.
Well, there's LSU crashing the glass. Klazak thought about a three. Here's Fisher slamming on the brakes and hits it.
Six quick points for Fisher here early in the third quarter.
Here's a feathery touch by Johnson out of the corner. Give her a triple. Klazak won't wait. And it spins out. Who's in the cylinder. Fisher again cleans it up. Another rebound for Angel Reese.
And this is where LSU needs to get stops and get out and run in transition.
Oh, what a nifty move there by Johnson against the Owls.
Flaugé Johnson sees a crack in the transition defense and just takes it.
Klazak down on the baseline. Long one coming, and that'll rattle home for Destiny Jackson.
Because they've been really good from three here in this game. This time, Destiny Jackson knocking down the big one to cut it to two.
And having another one now in a clutch situation here in March Madness. On the drive right down the lane, Michaela Williams, over a much bigger opponent in LSU. A catch by Angel Reese. Strong move up the two. Been going downstairs and rolling to the basket, and Gulifak for two. And they just won't quit. Williams dumping it downstairs, back out for her, a long three, yes. Fisher off to Jackson in the lane, and it's Angel Reese to get there first. Morrow got a fingertip on that. Rice is able to convert, though, underneath. Jackson.
Rice initiates a lot of their offense.
Van Lith fighting through the screen there. Klazak gives it back to the point guard. Hits it. Jackson with a triple. Not like Flores.
I don't think we have a cloud in the sky in 75 here in Baton Rouge.
That's right. Pretty good game inside, too, in terms of how close it's been. Van Lith will fire a two and knock that down. It's amazing watching LSU kick the ball away so often on their home floor. Trying to get that one downstairs. That won't drop. In transition, Van Lith.
Angel Reese sprinted and was yelling for the ball because she knew she was ahead of her matchup.
Morrow will lay it in at a great feed and 1-2. Fisher has fouled out of the game. That's a giant loss for Rice to lose their top player. An opportunity to really break away. But miss a shot, turn the ball over. It's just been that way today.
And usually Rice has answered with a three.
And another basket. This one by Destiny Jackson. Rice with turnover issues, 2-15 in the game. Williams lines it up, and with a feathery touch, Michaela Williams knocks it home.
Michaela Williams is LSU's best three-point shooter, and she had been struggling coming into that make. It had only been 4-23 coming in.
We mentioned snowing in Iowa. It's been snowing hard throughout the day. A gorgeous day here in Baton Rouge with temperatures up around 70. And a big drive by last tier Paula to knock it in. And yet, leading 62-51. Jump shot is going to be too strong. Second effort. Bukanevich with a second attempt, and that one she gets, a three-pointer. Rice is still kicking. Jackson weaving. A bounce downstairs and a quick strike. And Gulifak with a basket. Flaugé Johnson with a pull up at the elbow, knocks it down. Hitting that jumper. Destiny Jackson with the scoop, and yes. A round one victory that was quite a fight. Not many expected it. LSU wins by 10, 70-60, overcoming a ton of turnovers today